You raise the dead to life in the spirit. Lord, Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us into everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. In your mercy, grant that through this mystery, your servant Patsy, who has fallen asleep in Christ, may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns forever and ever. I'd like to invite Stephen and Rebecca to share God's word with us.
Reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the virtuous are in the hands of God. No torment shall ever touch them. In the eyes of the unwise, they did appear to die. Their going looked like disaster. Their leaving us like annihilation. They are in peace. If they experience punishment, as men see it, their hope was rich with immortality. Slight was their affliction. Great will their blessings be. God has put them to the test and proved them worthy to be with him. He has tested them like gold in a furnace and accepted them as a holocaust. When the time comes for his visitation, they will shine out as sparks run through the stubble. So will they. They shall judge nations, rule over peoples, and the Lord will be their king. They who trust in him will understand the truth. Those who are faithful will live with him in love, for grace and mercy await those he has chosen. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Trust in you alone. Yes, I will trust in you. I am already being poured out as a libation, and the time of my departure has come. I have fought good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept faith. From now on, there is reserved for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, righteous judge, will give me on that day, and not only to me, but also to all who have longed for his appearing. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for gospel language.
What does it mean to be virtuous? What is virtue? I think basically what it boils down to is simple goodness, kindness, charity. Virtuous is the kind of person who does the things that they know God wants them to do in every situation, in every circumstance. And that reading, probably written by someone who was trying to console people who had lost someone they'd known and loved. Someone who was a genuinely good person. And it was offered to them to bring them comfort in their loss, to bring them hope in their grief. That the person they'd known and loved, the person who had been a good, virtuous, morally upright person, was with God. Because grace and mercy await those whom God has chosen. Grace and mercy, everlasting life and happiness await those who live lives of virtue, who live lives of faith, who live lives of simple goodness. In our second reading, St. Paul was writing to St. Timothy towards the end of his life, knowing that the end was coming, but facing death without any fear, without any regret, because despite his sins, he knew that he had turned his life around. Despite his sins, he had come to know Jesus as his Lord and Savior, as his risen Lord and Savior, and was able to put his trust for everlasting life in that same Jesus. That's why he says, I fought the good fight, I finished the race, I kept the faith. And he knew that all that was ahead of him was the crown of righteousness. Hearing Jesus say to him, come, good and faithful servant, receive now the inheritance promised to you from the beginning of time because of your faith, because of your goodness, because of the work you've done for me, because of all the kindness you've shown to the people around you, because of the ways you've tried to encourage people in faith and in virtue themselves. And St. Paul offers words of reassurance to all of us just at the very end of that reading, where he says that that's not just for me, it's for all those who have longed for Christ's appearing. All of us who know Jesus as our risen Lord and Savior, all of us who believe in him, all of us who put our trust and hope in him, all of us who try to be guided by his Holy Spirit in everything we do and in everything we say, we can have that same hope, that same assurance that St. Paul had as the end of his life approached. Obviously, I didn't know Patrick Galeen. I just came here on the 1st of September. That was around the time when Patsy went into a nursing home to be cared for in the last few months of his life. Patsy went to this world on St. Patrick's Day. Sorry, I read that wrong. St. Joseph's Day, 2 days after St. Patrick's Day. It wasn't Patrick Joseph by any chance, was it? No, what was he? And his second name? Just the one name, and a good name it is too. He came into the world on the 19th of March, 1937. One of the Magdalene family, one of many within that house, spending all his life here in this parish, very much a family man, very much a man of his parish community, a hard worker, no matter what he was doing, no matter what he turned his hand to. He did it with great earnestness, with great eagerness. He did it wholeheartedly. Family was very, very important to him. And his family have assured me of his virtue, his goodness that our first reading talked about. His family have assured me that he and Henry, who gentlemen of this area have said and told me remembered him of all for his kindness, for the fact that he would never see anybody struck. If he saw something that needed to be done, he would do it. If he saw a way to do something good for someone, lend a hand to help them out, he would do it. He was a faithful member of this parish community, working here in this church, offering his services as a collector. Told he always presented himself immaculately, always turned out like a new pin, especially coming here to the chapel, because his faith was important to him. Important to him to be here, to take part in the life of the parish, to take part in the liturgical life of the parish too, to be a practicing member of the parish community. Patsy has left behind a legacy of faith and of goodness. And if the rest of us were to leave behind nothing else, I think we'd be doing a good job ourselves. If people would remember us for our faith, for our goodness, for that the faith that inspires us to be as good, as virtuous, as loving, as kind, as charitable, as patient, and as understanding as we possibly can, then that would be a good legacy to leave behind. Sadly, the last while of Patsy's life was marked with illness. We thank God for those who cared for her at home, and then in the nursing home where he died the other day. Thank God that there are people around there to care for us, show love to us, show compassion and understanding and patience whenever those qualities are needed. Today our focus is on Patsy, on his faith, on his virtue, on his goodness. We thank the Lord for everything that he was and meant to those who knew him, who loved him, who miss him today, and who go to miss him as time moves on. We ask the Lord to fill that void in your lives with the comforting presence of his Holy Spirit, to bring you comfort and consolation and strength in your own faith, in your own hope, and in your own trust in Jesus, who promises everlasting life to those who are virtuous, to those who are good, to those who are his faithful stewards and servants throughout their lives. In the hope that Patsy's faith and goodness will be rewarded. Pray for him, and we pray for all the deceased members of his family, all those who already made that journey before him. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them. May their souls, the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. If you'd like to stand now, please stand by Brian and Damien, lead us in the prayers of the
faith. For Patsy, your baptism must be contained to eternal life, that he may read now, be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For the family and friends of brother Patsy, they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of the Nazareth. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Patsy's friends, praise him, the enriched so deeply, which we are gathered here today in remembrance of his life. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who has helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That God may welcome unto his glory those of our family and friends who have departed this life, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
That all of us who are grieving, lost and passing, may be consoled and strengthened at this time, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Heavenly Father, thank you for all the many blessings you have given to us through the life of Patsy. We ask you now to hear the prayers we make in faith and hope and trust in your love, through Christ our Lord. Amen. If you'd like to sit again, please. We ask your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection is gone, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, Lord, for your faithful people, life is changed, not ended, and when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for us in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with all the hosts of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you held us worthy to be in your presence and serve you. Humbly, we pray that sharing in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Donal our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Patsy McGurlane, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, with St. Patrick, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, ever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
May these our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. We pray in silence for a moment of our fasting. Responses receive the soul and present them to God the Most High. Saints of God, come to his aid. Haste to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present them to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul and present them to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. For you, O Lord, we commend the soul of your servant Nancy. In the sight of this world he is now dead. In your sight may he live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed through human weakness, and in your goodness grant him everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In peace, let us take Patsy to his place of rest.